Welcome to the Inquendo Guitars Workshop and another part in the video series where I show you very in depth what goes into making one of my electric guitars. And in this episode I'm going to show you how I route the cavities for a Floyd Rose style tremolo bridge. So, let's go! So now with our neck in place, it isn't glued in yet, but it is in place, I can mark out the scale length 25 inches. In my case, 648, almost 48 millimeters. So that's what I'm going to mark out. And I think the mark is still there. This is my scale length, and it's very important to have your neck in place when you mark out your scale length, so you're absolutely sure it's correct. Be as precise as possible, take your time to mark, to be sure this is very accurate, especially with a Floyd Rose. You have to be very accurate and make sure all your lines are nice and square, and again perpendicular to one another. So this is my scale length. I'm going to mark it, scale. I hope it shows up on camera, I think it does. So this is my scale length. The next thing is to make sure that my center line is still correct. There can be some play, maybe we didn't do the neck joint as accurate as we thought we had. So what I'm going to do is take a straight edge, align it with the side of the neck, and draw in line on each side. And I can already see I'm a bit off, but that's not a problem, I hope. So with these two lines drawn in, I'm going to use my protractor to find the center at different spots and maybe adjust the center line on my guitar. There's always a little chance when doing, when aligning your neck, that you're slightly off. It's not uncommon to be just slightly off. It's not a problem, but you have to adjust at this stage. So now we have these two lines in. I'm going to find the center in a couple of different spots, and maybe draw in a new center line if necessary. From this point on, the neck will determine the center line on the body. I'm slightly off, just a half a millimeter, unfortunately. I'm going to double check it when it's this close. I'd rather double check it. The entire length of the neck. Yeah, this line is also correct. So my center line is just off. I have to redo it, unfortunately. But it's very important for the alignment of your strings, of your entire instrument, that this is correct. And yeah, when you're just half a millimeter off, it won't show in the end result. So that's not a problem. So let's draw in a new center line. and redraw. The line for the scale length. So that is now perpendicular to the new center line. Make sure it's absolutely square to or perpendicular to your center line, the new center line that is. Because everything we're going to do for the Floyd Rose tremolo is based of this on this line. Scale length, let's mark it. Scale. And now the nerve-wracking bit. I've made some templates, if you can see. And this is also a three-part template for routing a Floyd Rose. I've got my, let's call it a window or a frame I can place on the guitar, and it has markings on it for the scale length and the center line. And I've got two accompanying templates I can put in once the frame is in position. I can stick this to the body using masking tape and super glue, of course. And I can use this to route the different cavities needed. But first I have to determine the position of these mounting holes for the tremolo, for the studs of the Floyd Rose tremolo. All the dimensions I'm going to give you are based on the Charlotte Lockmeister tremolos. I've noticed that all Floyd Rose style bridges have different dimensions and need different measurements and such. So if you want to do a different brand of Floyd Rose tremolo, you have to recalculate and figure out the dimensions for the bridge you're going to use. I'm going to use the Charlotte Lockmeister tremolo. With that said, one of the first dimensions you have to figure out is where do these mounting holes need to be? Where does the studs need to be placed in relation to the scale length line? It's one of the dimensions I can't find in any data sheet, in any drawing. There are hardly any videos or instructions online on where to place these mounting studs. For the Charlotte tremolo, I found out the dimension between your scale line and the stud needs to be around 13 millimeters. There's a little bit of adjustment in all Floyd Rose style tremolo bridges for the scale length. And I found out the best position for these Charlotte bridges for your mounting studs is 13 millimeters. So that's the first thing I'm going to mark out on my actual guitar body, is from the scale length, I'm going to subtract 13 millimeters and draw in a second line for the placement of my studs. Scale length. Make sure it's all nice and square. 13 millimeters. I think my hand will be in the way, but there's our 13 millimeter line. And I'm going to draw in the line for the mounting studs. And again, a very, very important to get this right, because if you get these wrong, there's no turning back. It's very hard to fix. So the next step is to mark out where the studs need to be on our line. And for these Charlotte bridges, it's a very nice dimension. It's 74.3 millimeters center to center. I don't know the conversion to inches, so if you have a conversion calculator, please feel free. But in millimeters, it's 74.3 millimeters center to center. So that's what I'm going to mark out. 74.3 is 37 0.15. I'm going to mark it out as 37. I should be fine. So always double, triple check your measurements. And what I like to do is use the bridge itself. Check it once more. And of course, reference it with my template. Because although I have my holes drilled in my template, I just want to be absolutely, absolutely sure. So I'm going to triple, double check everything before I commit to the drill press. Yeah, and this looks to be just fine. So before I'm going to stick on my template, I'm going to drill these holes. So I'm at the drill press. As you can see, and as you if you've seen any of my previous videos, you know my drill press by now. But before I can start drilling, I have to determine the depth of my holes. And the Floyd Rose is going to be situated or placed on these studs with this threaded insert. So I have to measure the depth, or the height of this insert. And it's almost 20 millimeters. And I'm going to recess the entire bridge. That gives me some more play later on to adjust the action. And I'm going to recess it by 6 millimeters. So I have to add 6 millimeters at least to my 20, so it's 26 millimeters. And just to be sure, I'm giving myself a couple of millimeters more, so I'm going to drill my holes 28 millimeters deep. I've fitted in a 10 millimeter drill bit. It should be good for these studs for the Charlotte tremolos. It depends on the brand. I think Goto uses 11, 10 and a half, 11. 10 should be good for the Charlotte tremolos. Yeah, and now I'm ready to drill these holes. My drill press fortunately has a clamp attached to it to clamp down your workpiece. And yeah, because these holes are so critical to be correct, and I don't want my drill wandering whatsoever, I'm going to use this clamp. So if you don't have a clamp attached to your drill press, yeah, clamp down your workpiece on your table of your drill press. Yeah, I don't recommend drilling these holes by hand without any jigs or such. I'm going to use a bradle point drill bit, of course, and I don't use an awl to press in these holes beforehand. Because this is such a critical hole to drill, yeah, the awl, or the awl point usually makes a too wide of a hole that makes my bradle point drill bit just wander a little, and I don't want any wandering at all if possible when drilling these holes. So I'm going to use the point of my drill bit itself to make a center mark, and I have to be very careful, very precise when I do this. This should be good, and then I'm going to tighten my clamp. To set the depth on my drill press, I'm very lucky. My drill press has a digital gauge on it, and I can, with the drill bit resting on the body, I can zero it out, zero, and I can use this digital gauge to determine the required depth. If you don't have a feature on your drill press like this, yeah, set the depth as you're used to for your drill press, of course. Yeah, make sure you're absolutely dead center. And before drilling, I check and double check again. Yeah, and this looks absolutely fine. So fingers crossed, I start drilling. With the two holes for the studs drilled, it's time to put on the routing template. And I made my template in such a way that I can use two 10 millimeter dowels to locate my template in the perfect relationship to these holes. And now I can mark the outside of the mounting frame, remove it, and this will stay fixed in place, and use some masking tape to fix the frame for my template. And I put in a little screw to remove this template. Oh, or remove the entire screw. Whoops. And before I start routing, of course, remove this protruding bit of MDF. I have to come up with a solution for that. Now, the frame is in place. So now I'm checking with the second part of my template in place. I'm going to check the alignment of this template with the mounting holes. And I'm going to measure out the front of the template and the back of the hole. That's the easiest way to do it. It's 12 millimeters. And here it's the same. So this is aligned, and it's very important to align the template to your mounting holes. And that's because we've got, I've always used a very tight fit on my cavity. I think it's more beautiful. It looks pleasing to have a tight fit as possible. So there's only 1.5 millimeter gap in between the bridge and the cavity I'm going to route. And if it's slightly, if the template is slightly at an angle in relation to these mounting holes, that will mean your bridge will end up slightly at an angle in relationship to the sides, and that the lines won't be parallel. And even from a distance, it will look like the bridge is mounted at an angle. But when the cavity is the same as the bridge, although it might be just a little off from the rest of the guitar, it won't show, it doesn't have any impact. And it looks much better if these lines of the bridge and the cavity are of course as parallel as possible, especially with if you use a very small gap in between. You can make it easier on yourself to make your template just a little wider. So I should be set to go. Yeah, the mounting frame is fixed in place. Remove this template. Insert this one. And I'm going to start by routing out this section. First use a Forstner bit to remove a lot of this material. And I'm going to route this out to a depth of 30 millimeters to allow for the tremolo arm to swing back and forth, and for the entire tremolo block, of course. To route the first cavity, I'm going to use my 1/4 inch router bit. And my templates are set up for 1/4 inch router bit. I think this gives me the nicest radius for the corners and my smallest guide bushing or copy rig. It's a 7.9 millimeter guide bushing. Yeah, so let's start routing the first part of this cavity. Dust extraction, of course. So, and here's the first part of our cavity done. Nice and deep, I hope you can see it. And now it's time to do the rest of the outline. So I have to remove this template. hopefully I can get it out. Time for the next. And here we have the rest of the template. So now I can route this part to about 6 millimeters deep, and the back I'm going to route approximately 15 millimeters deep to allow for the action of the floating bridge, of course. And the easy thing is I can first route the entire thing to 6 millimeters deep and only do the back section here, route it even deeper to 15 millimeters. Here's a nicely routed Floyd Rose cavity. It looks nice and clean. Yeah. It looks square in relation to the mounting holes. Yeah, it looks great. Now of course we need to route the cavity for the springs, and then we can test fit the tremolo for the first time. So yeah, let me get things sorted out and I'll be right back to route the back cavity. So with the cavity on the front done, it's time to do the cavity, of course, for the springs for the Floyd Rose tremolo. And I'm going to use, of course, a couple of templates. It's a two-part template again. One template is for the cavity cover, so I can put this aside, and now I've got my cavity template. In order to determine the positioning of this template on the back of the body, how far back or forward we should place it, I've drilled a hole roughly in the center all the way through the body, and this hole is flush with this front edge we just created. So from the biggest cavity, the front edge, I just put the drill in my drill press flush against this face and just drilled all the way through. And now this gives me a mark on the back side flush with that face. It's an important measurement. So here's the hole I just mentioned, and here's the line I've drawn in just using my protractor of that hole. And now this line should be the same as this face over here. On my template, I marked out a line where that front face should be, so I can align my template just like this. So flush this line, in line with this line, and of course the center line should be in line. And I've drawn in a bit of a thick center line, but this should be okay. Now that I know my placement of my template, I'm going to mark the sides so I can put down some masking tape. Let's mark it all the way around, because I don't have much material here to put some masking tape. The control cavity is somewhat in the way. Maybe I can mark the entire cavity. So I'm going to stick down my template, and first I'm going to route again with a 1/4 inch router bit and my guide bushing. I'm going to route a cavity approximately 3 millimeters deep for my control plate or for my cover plate, and then I'm going to switch the copy rings, the guide bushings, and route the entire cavity. Let's stick the template in place. Some of you might be wondering, you never see me wearing any earmuffs, but I have these silicone hearing protectors. So yeah, let's start routing. All right, this is what our initial cavity looks like, just 3.5. I went a bit too far, so it ended up 3.5 millimeters deep. But that's okay, then I have to keep in mind to make my cover plate a bit deeper, and we have a lot of sanding to do also, so it will go down a bit. So after routing the first part, hopefully you can see it on camera, I switched my smaller guide bush or copy ring to a larger one, but I kept my 1/4 inch bit, and now I'm going to route the second part of this cavity, and I need to add an additional 11 millimeters. I want this entire cavity to be about 15 mils deep. My body is 45 millimeters thick, so with the cavity 15 minus of or 45 minus the cavity thickness of 15 leaves me 30 mils, and that's plenty for the 20 millimeters I need for my pickups. So I can always adjust or the pickup depth if needed, or I can deepen this cavity somewhat if needed at a later stage, because I still have approximately a full centimeter, so 10 millimeters play in the end, which is more than enough. Let's start routing the next cavity. Some ear defenders. And here we go. Looks good. And here's our cavity for the springs with a little edge for the cover plate to sit on. Something like this. I have to adjust it maybe a little. It's always very tight. But yeah, here we have our cavity for the Floyd Rose Tremolo. Now let's see how she fits. And I know it's a bit, maybe with the template underneath. And at first glance, we have a very nice and tight fit. Of course, I can only be sure as soon as the studs are in, but I'm going to do that at a later stage. Yeah, but for now, this looks great. The only thing I always do is to remove just a bit of extra material here at the end of the cavity, so my tremolo block has a bit more movement. Because you can see it can hit the edge there. When doing full dive, it can hit the edge. So I'm going to remove just a bit of material along this edge. So I'm probably going to route this another 4 or 5 mils deeper. So with the routing done, it's time to remove the template. And I like to clean up the edges straight away. I don't like the fuss left by the router. One nice routed cavity, if I may say so myself. And with the proper templates, I meant to say, with the proper templates, it isn't that difficult to do. Like I said in the beginning of this video, the most important is to be very precise with your initial measurements. Then have the right templates the right router bits or the right guide bushings and copy rings, and you should be fine. Yeah, I'm very pleased with the end result, and I only need to mount a shorter sustain block, but I have one, because as we can see, this is a bit too long, it's freestanding at the moment. But yeah, at first glance it looks to be perfect. So let's continue with routing the pickup cavities next. With the tremolo cavities done on this guitar, it's time to do the last bits of routing, and that's the pickup cavities. I'm going to install some Fishman Fluence in this guitar, some active pickups. I've never used them before, so I'm very curious how this is going to turn out. And I've chosen the brushed stainless steel version. Yeah, looks great. And of course, I'm going to use another template, and this is the template I use for all my pickup routes. So let's see if it fits these pickups. And it looks great, even the radius on the edges and the corners looks great. Very nice and tight fit, so we have to be very precise with positioning this template. But we should end up with a cavity even suitable for direct mounting, if you ask me. But I like to use pickup rings instead, and these also fits the Fluence pickups very well. So yeah, let's position the template and start the routing. Determining the placement of your pickups, especially when you use two humbuckers like I do, is fairly easy, especially for the bridge pickup, because that's, I believe, based on personal preference. You can have it as close to the bridge as you would like, of course resulting in a more trebly sound. So I like to keep about a centimeter between the edge of the pickup and the edge of my bridge, in this case the routing of my bridge, so I can mark it. And I'm going to measure out the center of my pickup ring, and that's where the mounting hole is for the pickup. It's 22 millimeters, so I can add 22 here. 22, and this is the center of my pickup. This is the center of my pickup. Of course, draw out this line a bit further. Like so. And this should allow me to place my template somewhat like this. So this is where my first pickup is going to sit, and it will leave me with just a small gap. I think this will be fine. And now for the neck pickup, I'm going to need to install the neck once more. Oh, here's my neck, fitted very snugly. And this one is very easy, because I want my pickup ring to be up against the end of the fretboard. I can mark these two center holes. And this should be the center of my pickup. And this is one of the reasons you don't want to have your neck installed and glued already, because it makes routing the pickup cavities very hard. And this should be the center of my neck pickup. I'm going to this one. I like to check things. 78. 78. Perfect. And this should be the position of my neck pickup. I hope you could see it on this weird camera angle. I think you could. So yeah, with these two positions now marked out, it's time to start routing. And this time I'm going to fix the template once again in place with some masking tape and super glue, of course. Use a Forstner bit to remove a lot of this material, and then use a regular router bit with a bearing to do the initial route of the cavity, and then use a 1/4-inch bit to tighten up these corners a little. Cavities are done. I've got my pickup cavities and of course the cavity for the bridge and the strings and the springs in the back. So the routing should be done for now. Yeah, my apologies if I didn't include any footage of me using the 1/4-inch bit to tighten up the corners of the pickup cavities. And that's because I didn't notice my memory card was full. So while I thought I was recording, it didn't record anything. So my apologies for that, but it's a very easy job to do. Just make sure the shaft runs along your template and just push your 1/4-inch bit into the corners so that they are nice and tight and even. Very simple job. I don't think I need to show you how I do this. And if you like me to show you, please leave a comment in the comment section down below when I do a separate video on routing and using different bits and different routing techniques. That's it for this episode. In the next episode I'll start carving the body. Very fun job to do, and maybe a lot of sanding, not fun as a job to do. But yeah, I hope to see you there. If you learned something from this video, please, and you like this video, please leave a like. It helps out a lot and I'd really appreciate it if you did. And of course, subscribe to my channel if you don't want to miss out on any of my future uploads. Yeah, that's it for this week's video. I hope you enjoyed it and I hope to see you in the next one. But until then, have a nice week.